Hello, good morning, my dear students. We are back with our physics lecture. We have started the lesson electric current and its effects. Are you getting? In the last video, we have discussed the symbol, electric components. Then we have seen this electric symbols and its components. Am I right? With this, we have also discussed about different electric effects. We have started the electric effects. In the last video we have discussed about the heating effect of electric current. Am I right? Then what are the applications of the heating effect of the electric current, that we have discussed in the last video. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the next type of the effect, that is magnetic effect of electric current. With this, we have also discussed about the fuse and MCB. In last video, we have discussed the different types of full form. What are the full form of MCB, ISI, then CFL. This everything we have discussed in the last video. In today's video, we are going to discuss the magnetic effect of electric current. So before we discuss this, we will have an activity of 14.5, that we have to take a cardboard tray from inside discarded matchbox, wrap an electric wire a few times around a cardboard tray. Place a small compass needle inside it. Now connect the free ends of this wire to the electric cell through a switch as shown in the figure 14.7. Now what exactly the connection it is? See, this is a wrap, this is a matchbox. This is a discarded matchbox. Discarded means what? Not in use. In that we have to keep an electric, we have to take a compass needle, and we have to wrap it with a wire. Can you see this connection is done? This is wrapped with a wire, and this whole connection is given to the cell and a switch, and here it is a bulb. When we will on the switch, this is a symbol for the switch and this is a symbol for the cell. As the switch will get closed, are you getting? As the switch will get closed, the bulb will start to glow. The magnetic compass will start to show some deflection. Means it will start to move. The needle will start to move. Are you getting? The deflection will be seen in this magnetic compass. Are you getting this? So this deflection was first observed. The magnetic deflection was first observed by the scientist Hans Christian Ørsted. This is a scientist who observed the first deflection. Are you getting? So this deflection was observed by the scientist named Hans Christian Ørsted. He was the first person to notice the deflection of a compass needle. Every time the current passes through the wire, we can see the deflection. So what is exactly the magnetic effect of the electric current? In short, how we can describe or how we can define the magnetic effect of electric current? Magnetic effect of electric current can be defined as, When electric current pass through the wire, the current carrying wire behaves like a magnet by producing the magnetic field around it. It will produce a magnetic field around it, and this is called as a magnetic effect of electric current. Are you getting? This is called as a magnetic effect of the electric current. So mostly the question is asked that who was the first person to see the deflection in the compass? That is Hans Christian Oersted, he was the first person to observe the deflection. He was the first person who noticed the deflection of the compass needle. Are you getting this? Related to this magnetic effect of electric current, there are the different applications we can use. That is, the first is of electromagnet. The word itself tells you, electromagnet means electricity and magnet. The word itself tells you what is exactly the electromagnet, electricity and a magnet. Now, what is electricity? What is electromagnet? Now, here is also one activity is given. Take around 75 centimeter long pieces of insulated flexible wire and iron nail. Iron nail, see, about 6 to 10 centimeter long. Wind the wire tightly around the nail in the form of the coil. Connect the free ends of this wire to the terminals of the sail through a switch as shown in the figure. Now see here, this is a nail is used. This is a nail. In that we have to wrap a wire. We have to wrap the wire. This connection should be given to the switch and the seal. And as the current will flow through it, through this circuit, as the switch will get closed, that time if you will bring some iron material here, it will stick to this nail. So, and as soon as when you will off the circuit, at that time this nail will disconnect, means the iron nails which has been stuck to this nail, it will loose, and thus this nail will falls down. So this, when the switch will get on, this nail will behave like a magnet. This nail will behave like a magnet, and the nails, the iron pins will stick to this nail. Are you getting this? So this is how the electromagnets work. Means electromagnet means when the current will pass, then this nail will behave like a magnet. Are you getting? And when the switch will get off, this will not behave like a magnet. This nail will not behave like a magnet. So this is a, there are different applications of the electromagnet. Which we can use in our day-to-day life. The applications of the, or what are the advantage of this electromagnets, that we will discuss in the next video. Once again, what is exactly the electromagnet? Electromagnet is a magnet consisting of a coil insulated to the copper wire wounded around it, and iron rod, this iron soft iron rod, that when the current will pass, it will behave like a magnet. Then if we want to be this to be a strong, if we want this to be a very strong, then we have to increase the number of coils. Number of turns around this nail. Are you getting? Or also we can increase the amount of current passing through this circuit. Are you getting? Here we have used here one cell. Here if there are the more magnet, more material of the magnets which get attracted, then we have to use here, instead of the one cell, we have to use 2-3, depend on the particular material. If you want to increase the strength of this electromagnet, either you have to increase this number of coils or we have to increase the number of cells. So there are the different applications we can use, that we will discuss in the next video. So today's work will be that you have to go through this magnetic effect of electric current and electromagnet. I hope you have understood it. Thank you.